for the week of December 26, 2011. This is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
Chief Petty Officers with the United States Navy and Japan Maritime Self-Defense Force keep up with tradition at the 25th Annual U.S. Navy and JMSCF CPO Joint Mochi Pounding Ceremony. The two organizations celebrate together to promote a common goal of friendship, said Chief Cryptologic Technician Donald Morrow.
Strengthens the bond between the Japanese Maritime Self-Defense Force and the United States Navy. Particularly with the events that happened this year, that bond was really forged even more, and this is kind of the culmination of that, where we can get together, reflect over the, how we've worked together over the last year as, you know, two military forces that are, you know, bound by one common goal, friendship.
Chief Cryptologic Technician Ned Lentz said that the event is not only fun, but it's important to maintaining good international relations.
This is important because it gives us an opportunity to maintain international relations and to show camaraderie between the two Chief Petty Officers Associations.
Morrow said that these types of celebrations provide an opportunity to gain a better understanding of Japanese culture.
This is the perfect opportunity to interact with the community, interact with the Maritime Self-Defense Force, and gain a greater understanding of that culture, of that background, so that in the future, whenever you interact with them, you're able to do so in a better way.
Petty Officer Shamira Purifoy, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
More than 300 single and unaccompanied sailors in Yokosuka attended the 4th annual Talk With Your Mouthful Steak and Eggs Breakfast on Christmas morning, which was sponsored by the USO and Yokosuka's Chapel of Hope. Jason Rouse, the Center Operations Manager at the USO in Yokosuka, said the event was a good opportunity to give back to the military community.
The people that are here on orders unaccompanied, you know, the single guys that are here by themselves, this is a way for us to give back a little bit to the community, show that, you know, we're thinking about you, we care about your well-being, and it gives them a place to go on Christmas morning. You know, it gives them a chance to socialize with some friends, maybe make some new friends, and all in all, I just think it's a lot of fun.
Petty Officer Dominique Segura said that without the USO's single sailor event, Christmas morning would have been just like any other day on duty.
Just working, finding food on post or something, but I always like family breakfast for Christmas, so a couple of us came over here, had breakfast. One of my friends won a prize.
Sailors who attended the breakfast also had the chance to win raffle prizes such as iPads, gift cards, and other assorted prizes. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
Kinnick High School, a Department of Defense Education Activity School at Yokosuka Naval Base, is making a push to increase competitiveness with international schools in the fields of science, technology, engineering, and mathematics education by offering a gaming technology pilot course and an animation course. Students recently visited Tactical Training Group Pacific Detachment Yokosuka to witness war gaming firsthand. Robert Tiffany said, their visit gives the students a glimpse of what types of opportunities they may have in a career in engineering and technology.
Today, they were able to apply what they've seen and done in the classroom to actual simulations that the military does on a routine basis. So hopefully what we've shown them is that what they're doing by creating games, gaming is one piece of it, but there's a bigger picture that they can get involved in with as well. We have four new projects. We have the gaming technology, which is going on right now. We also are piloting an engineering class, which is a robotics class. We're piloting green technology, and we're also piloting biotechnology within the DoDEA schools.
William Rossi said, high school students today will lead us into the next 20 to 30 years of war game technology.
We run war games and simulations to train the ships of the forward deployed naval force. I grew up playing games like Pong and Defender, and as modeling and simulation gets more prevalent in Navy training, we're going to need the next generation of experts in wargaming.
Petty Officer Adrian White, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.